The Genki ShadowCast is a very interesting product to discuss, as it showed up through Kickstarter, specifically promising low latency PC gameplay from your Nintendo Switch and PlayStation 5, but showed up right around the same time as other companies tried pulling one over on us, charging upwards of $80 for a rebadged Cant Link, the name we give to super cheap Cam Link knockoffs flooding eBay and Amazon for under $20. Video on those are linked below to get you up to speed. I received no end of requests to look at this last year, and it's finally here. Everything about it is weird, though. I'm EposVox, the stream professor. We review every capture card we possibly can on this channel, so naturally I wanted to get my hands on the ShadowCast and see what the hype was for myself. Did Genki just rebadge a Cant Link clone, or did they really make something low latency and impressive here? Well, let's talk about it. What you get for your $50 purchase is a tiny little capture card, a USB-C cable with a right angle on one end, and a USB-C to Type-A adapter, something you can choose to not order and save $5 through their website for. Where this device stands out from similar clone capture cards is instead of a USB Type-A jutting out of the end of the case, you have a full-size HDMI end, with USB-C female on the other end. I find it hilarious that Genki chooses to bundle and charge extra for a simple USB-C to A adapter when most people are likely to have USB-C to A cables at home, but not include an HDMI extension cable, as this particular setup can be limiting for for some use cases, especially for some of the ones that they advertise on their website, such as connecting it to a camera. Very few cameras have full-size direct HDMI ports on them. The shell is made of plastic. Nothing to really write home about. The entire design of this product seems specifically built around the idea of fitting it into the Nintendo Switch dock to allow you to connect it to your laptop to use instead of a TV. This is just such a bizarre selling point to me, given that the Nintendo Switch literally has a screen built in. But of course, you can use this with any game console that has HDMI out, as long as the wider HDMI plug will fit. I note this as while it's close to an HDMI cable, it is a little bit wider and it was a tight fit on my HDMI switcher's outputs. Missing here, though, is any sort of HDMI pass-through. The objective of this product is to use your computer, primarily targeting MacBooks and iMacs here, as a TV, rather than connecting it to a TV, so you don't get that pass-through connection at all. Also, don't let that USB Type-C fool you, though. Just like all of the cheapo sub-$100 clone capture cards I've been reviewing over the past year, this is a USB 2.0 device through and through. This is both confirmed by USB TreeView and the fact that, also like all those clone devices, it only supports MJPEG encoding. This means that, unlike most modern USB 3.0 and PCIe connected capture cards, it's not providing uncompressed video to your computer. Instead, it's sending a signal that's already compressed with effectively JPEG compression. This adds latency, which affects your ability to play from that preview, it requires more work for your CPU to decode the feed, and it adds compression artifacts to the video and degrades the quality before you even compress it for streaming or video making. It's not great. Plus, just like the $5 to $20 Cant Links I've reviewed over the past year, it doesn't actually support 60fps at 1080p. Yep. Here we go again. You can send up to 4K 60Hz to this capture card from your next generation console, but the chipset on board can't process a 1080p 60 feed. So you either capture at 720p 60 for a blurry mess, or 1080p 30 pretending to be 1080p 60 for an unstable mess. What's fascinating is the inconsistencies in the information being presented by Genki. On their website, they say 4K 60 console's input is supported, but on the user manual it says only 4K 30 is supported. Overall, this is incredibly disappointing, and it really hurts the viability for playing on your computer on top of looking gross for streaming or content creation. Surprisingly, I was able to actually push 1440p at 144 or 120Hz to the ShadowCast with display cloning in Windows, so it's apparently a flexible little device. Obviously, you're still limited to 1080p 30 or 720p 60 capture, and the MJPEG doesn't look great, but I didn't notice any of the expected egregious scaling artifacts or anything, so that's pretty neat. I guess streaming PC games on a device designed to play console games on your PC is a tad silly, but you can. Also, this is a UVC capture card, which means it's plug and play and it works on Windows, Mac, and Linux, and will show up in all of your video chatting apps as a webcam as well. For play on the computer, I generally always consider OBS's preview to be a no-go with capture cards. It just has just enough processing or render delay to be too slow, even with the fastest capture cards I've tested, and you typically want to rely on the first-party apps provided by your capture card manufacturer or something like Amarec for trying to play from. Even still, I have found the fastest capture cards I've tested to still not be playable for input-sensitive games like first-person shooters from these previews. This was something I actually got into a debate with Linus over way back in 2018 involving a Nintendo Switch as well. I maintain my stance from that time. How does the ShadowCast fare for live play then? About as expected, which is not great. I wanted to test both with OBS Studio for my usual capture card latency data and with Genki's own app, which we'll cover more in a minute. I got anywhere from 115 to 120 milliseconds of latency in performance mode for 720p 60 and 106 to 113 milliseconds of latency for resolution mode for 1080p 30. In OBS Studio set to 1080p 60, I got the same latency, about 106 to 120 milliseconds of latency with a slightly faster rate of 97 to 103 milliseconds of latency at 720p 60. So in this case, at least on Windows, OBS is actually a tiny bit faster than the Genki Arcade app, so Overall though, this is definitely on the much higher end of latency compared to other capture cards I have reviewed. It's a pretty slow card, even compared to the original Cantlink that I got my hands on. Combine that with the existing input latency of your computer or laptop monitor, and you will have a bad, bad time with any game that has a lot of sensitivity to input timings. As expected, trying to play a first-person shooter from their app or OBS was nauseating, especially when trying 1080p and losing half of your frames. It's just not great. I did have luck, however, playing Returnal through this. It's a third-person shooter, and it was definitely far worse of an experience than playing just plugged into your monitor or TV, but I was able to play, not get nauseous, and still do pretty well just with the significant challenge. Less input-sensitive games, especially from the Switch, like they market, were more manageable. I guess if your goal here is to just play Animal Crossing on your MacBook screen for some reason for a slightly bigger display, this has you covered. Let's talk about the app after we talk about my own video service, where you can get an extended cut of this video, including Teardown and other details, and many of my other videos. The site is called Nebula. My videos are higher quality there, ad-free, and often extended from the YouTube versions. We've partnered with CuriosityStream as well. Nebula features YouTube's top education creators such as MKBHD, Thomas Frank, LowSpecGamer. CuriosityStream saw what we were doing for educational content and wanted to partner up. We've worked out a deal where if you sign up with the link in the video description, you not only get access to CuriosityStream and their library of thousands of educational and documentary titles, but you get access to Nebula as well for free for the entire duration of your subscription to CuriosityStream. Even better, CuriosityStream is currently offering 41% off of their annual plan, now through Father's Day, making it less than $12 per year for both CuriosityStream and Nebula. While you're there, check out Cosmic Encounters. It's a documentary about space, filmed in space. Head to curiositystream.com/epos for a streaming deal out of this world for both sites for under $12 per year. Genki developed and released an app for the ShadowCast to allow lower latency gameplay on your computer, claiming on the Kickstarter page that their app is 50 milliseconds faster than OBS Studio. Not in my testing. The app lets you choose between performance mode, copy editor needed, and resolution mode, aka 720p 60 and 1080p 30 respectively. On Mac, you can take screenshots and record video, on Windows you cannot. But they also released a web app for Chrome, which specifically looks for the ShadowCast device and lets you record and take screenshots as well. Useful for computers that you can't install apps on, though the Windows app doesn't actually require installing. They are repackaging the video here. The ShadowCast already takes in MJPEG video. This can be directly packaged in an AVI or MOV container and saved directly to then edit or post to YouTube. Virtual Dub on Windows and GUVC View on Linux can do this, but for some reason, they re-encode the video to H.264 in an MP4 container on Mac and AVC in a WebM container on the Chrome tool, further degrading quality. Like I said, the ShadowCast is just really weird. It's marketed really well to appeal to newcomers to the capture card scene, and it seems a lot of people are happy with their purchase. But there's just much better options out there, and at worst case, you could have paid a fraction of this price for the same product. I don't know, it just bugs me. It's not my job to dump on a product people enjoy, but also, I can't recommend people go and try to enjoy this on their own. If you want to play your console games on your computer, especially a Mac computer, and want a slightly higher guarantee that it will work, the Genki ShadowCast is an option. But as a capture card, it's not a great buy, and it's sad to consider how many people might play their next-gen beautifully rendering game consoles with this blurry mess. I will give Genki credit. They did what I said during my Atomos Connect capture card clone review was necessary. They did more than rebadge a shell. but they're still using the same guts as many of these cheapo capture cards use, and it's not a product of quality as a result. Product links will be in the description below. As always, hit the like button, get subscribed, and join us on Discord to chat about this. I'm EposVox. We'll meet again.